You know, as a quarterback, you're like, oh, I should have thrown it better. I needed to throw it better. And quite frankly, that ball was like off the end of his fingertips. And I'm sure that Evan said, I didn't say anything after the game. I was trying to get to bed. But Evan, I'm sure, would probably tell you that he needs to make that catch and all this other stuff. But that ball was, I mean, it wasn't like right there. You know, I wanted it to be right there for Daniel Jones. I was rooting for that kid, especially after that long run where he stumbles down around the 5-yard line. I was thinking to myself,
"Thank God they scored a touchdown,
dude." If that were me running, I probably would have fell down after 20 yards. I mean, you never see like a hole like that, and then all of a sudden the kid takes off, and you can see, like there are times where the touchdown pass for Sterling Shepard, for instance. Mm-hmm. He knew exactly where he was going with that ball, and he rifled it in there, and it was perfect. The interception, the one that came off of Evan Ingram's fingers, he was duped. He thought that they were blitzing. They showed a double A-gap blitz. They backed out of it, and he panicked, and he threw an inaccurate pass, and it goes off of Evan Ingram's hands, and it gets intercepted. The fumble at the end of the game, that should have never happened. They should have never had to have that happen.
Right.
And the defense, basically collapsed on the last two series for the Eagles. And quite frankly, Carson Wentz is playing like a maniac. He's running around all over the place, just throwing the ball up indiscriminately, giving the other team a chance to make plays. But then he comes back and he makes throws like he's the all-pro that he was 3 years ago or 2 years ago, whatever it was. You know, this is a really, really frustrating game for the Giant fans. We thought it would be close. I thought it was going to be a little bit more high scoring just simply because, the defenses are okay. They're not great. But I guess the offensive injuries for the Philadelphia Eagles somewhat kept it close. But, it's so frustrating to watch the Giants because they're close. They're close every game, it feels like. They're in the game, and in this case, they got the lead late in the game,
And
they can't seal the deal. And that's both on offense and defense. It's not just Evan Ingram. I mean, there are times where Evan Ingram looks unstoppable, for God's sake.
He's tantalizing. I mean, he's one of those guys that's got so much talent. You feel like he can be a superstar in the league, but there's always something holding him back. And what was different about this loss was in those other games, the Giants were down. They were hanging around. Then they were down late in the game, and they were driving with an opportunity to win, tie, take the lead, whatever, and they weren't able to get it done. This one, they did everything they needed to do. I mean, I was so impressed with the goal line stand and then the drive down the field on the road for that touchdown. At that moment, there was no thought in my mind that they were blowing the game. They were in complete control. And I was getting a lot of stuff from Daniel Jones that I wanted to see. Like the touchdown pass to Golden Tate. He hadn't made a throw like that all year, I felt like, where it was contested. The corner was right on the wide receiver, and he trusted his guy, put the ball up there, and he said, screw it, I'm going to have him make a play, and he did. So everything in the defense was showing up. I mean, there was everything about this game that you loved, and you felt like what Joe Judge was teaching these guys was coming to fruition. And then all of a sudden, this defense that was so stout that had just come off that incredible goal line stand fell apart. It's like they couldn't finish at all. They turned into a completely different unit. I mean, and even the face mask to Jason Kelce down there on the goal line before the game-winning touchdown, that's another break that they got. And then right after that, boom, touchdown pass. It's like,
Carson Wentz at times, man, looks like he's unstoppable. I mean, he made some throws last night that were just, they were brilliant. I don't know how else to describe them, but then he makes decisions and he runs around and plays a lot of sandlot football because he feels like he has to. Troy and Joe were talking about it last night about how hard he works every single game. And I know that Phil has said this numerous times on the NFL Today, and I've actually stole it from him a few times, that it's exhausting watching Carson Wentz play sometimes because of the amount of energy that he plays with and the amount of, fearlessness that he plays with. But he also does some dumb things on the field that are, if you don't win the game, they're inexcusable. But if they win the game, you would call them teachable moments. You know, overall, it's like a game that we thought we were going to see. We thought it was going to be close. We thought we both picked the Giants in the points. And, it's just completely so frustrating. And now you have to wonder, Are the Giants now in the Trevor Lawrence sweepstakes?
I don't know, man. I thought about this. It's one of the first things I thought about because when the game ended, I was like, this team just can't win. I mean, honestly, the one win that they had, you know, could have been a loss if Ron Rivera, you know, if the Washington football team ends up converting that two-point conversion or he kicks the extra point and they lose in overtime. They could very easily be winless at this point. But then I just... To me, the Jets have still shown us nothing that they can compete. The Jets have not even played a game like this last night. The Jets aren't even in a position to blow a lead. I don't see it. I think that the Giants will continue to fight, and this one's going to be a tough pill to swallow and one that they're not going to get over quick, but I still think they end up with at least 4 wins. At the very least, they'll get a couple more because I think they're going to continue to get better. It's the best game they played. I mean, as much as I hate to say it because they blew this lead again in Philadelphia. It's 3 straight years they've blown a double-digit lead in Philadelphia at some point. This is the best game they played. It was.
I thought the first half, that you know, they got a few breaks, but you know they didn't have the ball at all in the first half, I felt like. Carson Wentz was running all over the place. They were holding on to the football.
Like 5 plays in the first quarter.
Right, exactly. The time of possession was obviously lopsided and everything. It's amazing. It's tantalizing. There are times where, and you saw it again last night when Daniel Jones fumbled at the end of the game. When did I told you, when does he get in trouble?
When he holds on to the ball too
right.
long.
Like when he has time.
Yeah.
Like when he has time, that's when all of a sudden something's missing, you know, and that fumble came after probably 4.5-5 seconds of having enough time because I think they were only rushing 3 at that point. And I know it's hard to find the open guys and you have no timeout lefts and things of that nature, but you know there are things that he does in games where it's just amazing. I mean, the balls that he can throw and the plays that he can make, and I know that it's in him. I can see it, but there's also got to be. You know, there's got to be some sort of improvement. I don't necessarily know that yesterday was totally an improvement, but maybe we're talking completely different right now.
If Evan Ingram catches the ball, yes. I was going to say, all he has to, because that, to me, and I understand it wasn't perfect.
It wasn't.
But to me, that was the throw he needed to make in that situation. And to win games like this on the road against a division team that you never beat, you know, you got to make that play. I mean, this wasn't, you weren't diving to catch the ball. I mean, to me, that was the throw you wanted. And Daniel Jones, we would be talking differently. We'd still be joking around about him falling down, and thank goodness they scored a touchdown on that drive still, because then people would be just clowning him forever for not getting in the end zone. But he did all the things that I asked. I mean, and that fumble probably wouldn't have happened, as you said earlier, because the Giants shouldn't have been even in that position to try to get a field goal, get in field goal range at the end of the game. But they made a concerted effort. You know, Jason Garrett, Joe Judge, Daniel Jones made a concerted effort to be more aggressive in this game. And he was. And he was doing the things that we were asking for. That big run was extremely impressive as he broke away from everybody. It was a gigantic hole, but still, he looked the part. I don't think we'd be criticizing Daniel Jones one bit. We'd be talking about that throw to Evan Ingram when his balls were to the wall and he made the throw and he won the game. That's what we'd be talking about, and the guy dropped the ball.
Yeah, it's tough. I wish that ball would have been about 3 inches shorter, just a little bit shorter to make it a little bit easier on Evan. I don't know, maybe Evan misjudged it. Maybe he slowed down. I don't know. You'd really have to look at it, and you'd probably have to ask each player what they saw, but they had man coverage, and you can see what happens when they have man coverage on Evan Ingram, and he can actually start striding down the sideline. Like, you can't stay with him. He's too fast. Yeah. And right. So he is a very difficult cover in situations like that. And they caught Jim Schwartz in the absolute perfect defense. They had the right call on, and then it just comes down to execution. And, you know, whether it's a little bit too far or he doesn't stretch enough or doesn't dive for it or whatever you want to call it, it was just absolutely a microcosm of what the Giants season has been. Mm-hmm. It is really a microcosm of what the Giants season has been. It's been so close, but yet they're still having trouble finishing both on both sides of the ball, too, because, you know, let's face it, they had the lead. And they gave up the lead within the last 5 minutes. And they had a 2-score lead within the last 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I don't know what to tell you. It's just, And I know I wake up this morning at all these texts from all my Giant fan friends and everything. This guy sucks. Get rid of this guy. You know, everybody's ready to, you know, throw everybody out. And I'm like, God, man, it's like, I understand. I'd hate to have my team losing too. And there are certain guys that, look, Andrew Thomas is having a hard time at left tackle.
Right, which is a big problem for Dave Gettleman.
He had no preseason, no work on the field. Everybody here just got thrown into these games.
Neither did Mekhi Becton. Before he got hurt, he was hurling people off the field to the sideline.
But he got hurt, you know, because he didn't, you know, I mean, let's say you can't, I don't give a damn how good you are. You're not very good if you're not on the field.
Yeah.
So
quarterbacks that are. I mean, you can't just give me the no training camp excuse for everything.
I'm giving it to you for rookies, and I'm telling you how hard it is to play. And the one play that they sacked Daniel Jones on, one of the sacks, you know, was something that every normal left tackle in the league that's been around for 3 or 4 years handles easily. He gets sucked in, linebacker blitz around him, sack for Daniel Jones. And he's standing there, and he goes, you know, he knows it's his guy. He just hasn't seen that. He hasn't seen it enough. I don't want to put this guy in the Eric Flowers category. Basically threw him out of here, and they were sick and tired of it. You know, these kids are kids, and they need time. And that's part of the frustrating aspect of all of this. Is that, you know, you have a lot of young guys trying to figure it all out together, and with the new coaching staff and everything else, and they're fighting their ass off. They're playing hard. I don't care what anybody said. There's no disgrace in the way that they played. The disgrace is when you get beat by double digits every freaking week.
Oh, sure.
That's where the disgrace lies. This is not a disgraceful performance. This is a disappointing, frustrating, and broken heart performance is what it is.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the Jets have not had a moment all year like the Giants had with that fourth down, fourth and goal stop, and then that drive down the field for a touchdown. I mean, that right there was...
That's an awesome series of plays for the New York Giants.
It was exactly what you wanted to see them do and what Daniel Jones needed to do to restore faith in him. But right after that, everything fell apart. Absolutely everything.
And, you know, you talk about players, you know, you got to have an understanding of where we are in the game. You know, so you know Philadelphia is going to be moving the ball down the field. You know Philadelphia is going to be trying to push the envelope. You know Philadelphia is going to be playing desperate on offense.
Right.
So what's the one thing that you don't want to have happen if you're a defensive back?
Well, have a guy get behind you.
You just can't let it happen.
Right.
You just cannot allow that to happen. And that to me is again, it's part of a learning process.
Yeah, and I wonder if we had looked, if the Giants weren't right there in this terrible division and the storyline going in wasn't, hey, if they win this game, they actually have a shot to be in first place by the end of the weekend in the NFC East because it's so bad. I wonder if we'd look at this loss differently and just say, well, it's another step forward. They're getting closer. Joe Judge has really got something because it's just the fact that you really, honestly could have, if things broke a certain way, been in a tie for first place in the NFC East if you won this game by the end of the weekend, if Dallas ended up losing to Washington. So, I mean, I just maybe if the Giants were totally out of it and the Dallas Cowboys were undefeated or whoever was undefeated at this point, the Giants played the same game, we would have said, you know, that's another step in the right direction for a team that's learning. And I also wonder, are we warped with the Giants because we also see the Jets every week? Like, do we have a better than positive attitude about the New York Giants because the other team in town is the worst team in football? If we had a good team here, then the Jets, would we be looking at the Giants as a total disgrace? Or is it the fact that we just have a completely warped sense of reality because we've got the worst team in the history of the game playing here as well?
Well, the good news for the worst team in the history of the game up to this point is that it looks like they're going to get their quarterback back, and they should have their full trio of starting wide receivers, including Denzel Mims, on the field against Buffalo on Sunday. So hopefully, I don't know what Jet fans want right now. I think everybody wants Trevor Lawrence.
You want to lose.
Right, yeah. But, you know, Ryan Lewis is the cornerback that Fulgham goes over and just beats, and I mean beats literally by 5 or 6 yards. And the thing about that is, you know, Carson Wentz puts it right on the money. And Evan Engram beats his guy, and it's just a little bit, just a tad bit too far. And I know that all the Evan Engram haters out there are going to hate on Evan. We've actually pointed his out his drops already this season. We've pointed out the enigma that he is as a player, because when you see that explosiveness off the line of scrimmage and you see him get away from the guy who's covering him, then you recognize just how good he can be. The interception was on Daniel Jones. He was completely fooled. Schwartz showed blitz. They backed out of the blitz. He panicked. He threw the ball. That's not Evan Engram's fault. That's on Daniel Jones 100%. So in a game where you're going to end up making about, 35-40 decisions, Daniel Jones made really one terrible decision. And that was because he overreacted to something that didn't happen.
Yeah. Let me ask you, if Evan Engram catches that ball, are we saying, what a great catch by Evan Engram, do you think, this morning? Or were we saying, man, when they really needed to make a play, Daniel Jones made a great throw? Because I don't think it was a catch that was like, oh, man, what a remarkable catch with the game on the line. I mean, when I watched that, I was like, the son of a bitch dropped it. That's what I thought. I didn't think, like, man, it could have been perfect.
If you go back and watch it, I watched it like 4 times this morning. It's a catch that he probably, I don't want to get into the weeds about this, but it's probably a catch that he feels like he should make. But I don't know if he just didn't see it right or whatever. But that ball could have been a better, just a little bit shorter to make it easier on him. That's all. It could have hit him like, all right, can you see me?
Yeah, I can see. Always see.
It could have hit him right here. Right.
Okay. And it was out here. His fingertips. Yeah. I go. Okay. I mean,
so just a little bit. And look, as a quarterback, you would like to think that I would take the side of the quarterback.
I know.
But I'm looking at it and I'm just saying, it goes right through like it's like the fingertips, and then with those gloves, they should always catch those balls. But you can see either he has to lay out for that or that ball just needs to be a little bit shorter.
Man, I wish Evan Engram at some point this season turns into that player, stays healthy for the entire year, and turns into that player that he's just right on the cusp of being. He's right on the cusp of being there. And there's so many great tight ends in the league, and he can be one of them. And he's got the right attitude. He's got the skill set. He's got everything. See, even watching this again, man, I'm just like, catch the ball.
And the thing about it is that Giant fans probably have, if I had to go by my text messages, I would say it's like a 75-25, get him out of here already. It's
Evan
like
Evan Engram. Yeah, I know.
And it's really unfortunate because I'm telling you, the kid can play.
And he's a great guy. He's not one of these guys that's like mailing it in. We talked to him a couple times over at training camp, a couple years in a row. I mean, he's the type of guy you want on your roster.
I feel like he's beating himself up. I'm sure he's beating himself up over this, and I'm sure he's, but then again, a lot of his teammates should also be saying, well, if I'm Ryan Lewis, the mistakes that I made at the end there, are highlighted and one of the reasons why we lost. If I'm Daniel Jones, I fumbled on, the last play, that's on him. I mean, there's a lot of mistakes that go around, and people tend to forget that it is the ultimate team game, and there are a lot of mistakes that are made all over the field. And it's unfortunate that Evan Engram has one that, is highlighted simply because of when it happened in the game. And I understand that's what people are going to do. That's the natural reaction to it. But there are enough mistakes to go around on an entire roster, and that's where Joe Judge comes in. Joe Judge is basically got the point out to his team that we're all in this together, man. And one guy makes a mistake that everybody sees, that's fine, because there are a million other mistakes that so many other guys have made that nobody even understands or sees or can even comprehend that also led to this loss. And I'm sure the last 5 minutes, out of the 48-man roster or however many guys are dressing these days, I would probably tell you 75% of them all made a mistake somewhere along the line that led to ultimately losing this game.
Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the red bell so you're notified when we have new content.